Flemington, 1890, and the scene of one of Australia's greatest sporting achievements. At the invitation of the Victoria Racing Club, a record number of spectators pay up to 10 shillings and sixpence on that warm spring afternoon to witness Carbine storm home to win the prestigious Melbourne Cup, carrying a whole £53 more than the second-placed horse, Highborn. As a tribute to this legendary horse that made its name in Australia, Bronte Porcelain had produced a model of Carbine with the jockey most associated with him, Mick O'Brien, up in a limited edition of 25. Every part of the model was made in-house at Bronte Porcelain, in their studio and factory nestled amongst the hills of rural Worcestershire. Here they produce an exceptional range of china pieces known for their quality and detail. From research to sculpting through to decoration, all processes are totally by hand, and from concept to finished item, the model has taken over 18 months to complete. The model of Carbine is the latest in a series of notable animals from the equine world, including racehorses, breed champions, and in particular, Balmoral Curlew, a handsome Highland pony belonging to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. Who is seen here receiving the piece, which was commissioned by the Royal Warrant Holders Association, on her 80th birthday. The research for the project was coordinated by Lucy Price, with tremendous professional help from Penny Tripp, the Art and Heritage Curator at the Victoria Racing Club, Flemington, who supplied many of the original black and white photographs that were used. The model was sculpted in specially formulated wax-based material by Bronte sculptor Graham Gordon, who has depicted Carbine with jockey Mick O'Brien in alert mode in the parade ring. During the sculpting process, the model was critiqued by Terry Pendry, stud groom to Her Majesty the Queen, who advised on the concluding stages of the sculpting. Following completion, the model was cut into 21 pieces, each having a special key to enable it to fit into its neighbour in the casting process. The mould maker will initially make a mould for each separate part directly from the original model. From these master moulds, prototypes can be made, as well as a further 42 working moulds from which the addition pieces will eventually be cast. Liquid, fine English bone china slip was then poured into each mould, and the 21 hollow pieces thus formed were assembled to make a clay model of Carbine and O'Brien. Once the caster has removed the excess clay from each component part, the process of redefining the detail can begin, prior to the model's assembly. The keys that were made by the sculptor on the original wax model will dictate the position of each corresponding clay part. This should ensure an accurate rendition of his original sculpture. In order to ensure that the model remains upright during the firing process, a complex series of clay props were then made and fitted. The model, with props, is then allowed to dry out for 1 month prior to the initial biscuit firing, reaching a peak temperature of 1210 degrees centigrade, over a 48-hour cycle. Following the removal of the props, the model was glazed with a borosilicate glass coating, fired to reach a temperature of 1060 degrees over an 18-hour cycle. After glazing, Tracy Arrowsmith, senior artist at Bronte, painted the model for the first of three times using inorganic ceramic pigments mixed with glass flux. Extensive research of carbine was used, relying heavily on oil paintings and black and white photographs. After each application, the model was fired at 800 degrees centigrade. There was then a final application of colour at a lower temperature, firing at 750 degrees centigrade. The model of Carbine and Mick O'Brien are set into a French polished kiln-dried solid sapile wood plinth. Set into each long side of the plinth are panels depicting the finish of the 1890 Melbourne Cup race. The panels are glazed bone china hand-painted by Bronte Special Commission artist Tony Young, using sepia tones to emulate one of the photographs used for inspiration. Located into the front panel is a very special badge based on data provided by museum curator Penny Tripp, which inspired VRC members' badge for the years 1890 to 1891. Again, the badge was made from fine bone china, but in this case was decorated with pure ceramic gold and platinum.